Hello everyone, and welcome back to Borderlands 2 DLC Quest. We are here in Magni's Lighthouse, and it's time to proceed. And I know this has become a bit of an irregular series, but I've not forgotten it. There's some series which I've eventually just decided, you know what, I'm not gonna finish this. Oh hey, it's a badass.
You are nothing.
I don't know why I'm still taking damage actually. This is odd. There we go. Guessing it was a poison over time, but I don't know. It lasted a bit longer than I'd expected it to. Anyway, no matter. No worries. Ooh. Okay, so someone's throwing explosives, but they're not hitting me. Oh, it's the mine layer, obviously.
If you reach the treasure before me, which you won't, of course, but just in case, be careful of the Leviathan. It ate Roscoe, as I may have already mentioned, and Blade's notes say it will die to protect the treasure chamber.
You know what? I think it will die. Always remember, stalkers best dispatched with an electric weapon of some description. Okay, I think that's it. I think this way, yeah. I always get a bit lost on this map. I know I'm being a bit quiet, but well, when there's nothing to say.
Enough.
Well, what is there to say, really? Oh yeah, there's some. I don't know if I still remember how to get up there. I think you want to jump up on this and then up here. Yeah. And this gives you this place, which is apparently hard enough to find that it gives you badass tokens when you find it. And also, this is, you need to do this if you want to light up the entire map here. You know, remove all the blackness. I think that's where you go for a specific side quest, which I haven't got. And I might never get. I'm not sure if I'll bother going back to fetch it. It's from the sensor bot, if I recall correctly. It's not very long, and it's not terribly funny, so, as I said, I might just skip it. We don't want to go here, that would be silly. I believe this might be where we want to be. There will be enemies, I'm ignoring them for now. Actually, they don't spawn until I activate this, apparently. I thought there was a group you have to kill before. It's a very, very slow lift, so you're doing this kind of... you're doing this Half-Life style thing where you wait for a very slow elevator and kill enemies while you're waiting. I do like getting short-range sniper rifle kills. I think there's a message in a bottle. I'm wondering if I can make this jump. Whoa, that was close. I hit some sort of invisible barrier there, which really slowed down my fall, or... I guess shortened it. But it just about made it anyway. There you go. Yeah, we need this message in a bottle to get the... And I think it might be the last of the Captain Blade things. Not sure. But yeah, we can only get this after we've used the lift. So obviously it makes sense to get it beforehand. I'd remember this lift sequence being a lot longer also. Perhaps it is longer in co-op because of... I think I've never soloed these DLCs. I might be wrong there. Yeah, as I said, excuse my quietness, but, well. I don't want to fill the video with mindless nonsense just to keep myself talking. So, yeah. Mostly the game speaks for itself, really. I mean, it's not as bad as Bastion, where you literally can't get a word in edgeways, but... You know, it's action, you shoot stuff, not really much to comment on, I guess. But then people need to keep in mind the value of silence.
You're at the top of the lighthouse? Lovely! Just find somewhere to place Blade's compass, and we'll find out exactly where the treasure is buried.
Okay, activate.
What's happening?
So yeah, this light thing apparently now points somewhere. Just roll with it, I guess. SMG gun damage? Nah, I'm okay. Now, I'll just switch back to the X marks no message in a bottle. Thing is, I don't remember where thing is. You can't get it from below, you have to jump down to it. Somewhere over here, I believe. Yeah. See the X?
Not my friend, and don't worry, I still need your help to get past whatever traps there might be in the treasure chamber. I will not betray you until we find the treasure room.
Right. I found this one very difficult to get on my first try, so.
I'm hiding the blasted treasure. It got my entire crew killed. But if you want to die looking for it, have fun. This is Captain Blade, signing off for good.
I think this time it's actually correct. This is the last piece of the treasure. Okay. Yeah, the only way to get to this is to jump down from the lighthouse. Luckily, no fall damage, so that's cool. I know when first we came to this DLC, we always... All the other bottles you could kind of get... Like, from the moment you took the quest, you just went to the location. But in this case, the location being right there, you can't get to it unless you... proceed the main quest enough to get up to the lighthouse.
You're going just down, kidding! Jackass. This has honestly been a lot of fun, but this is where I'm dying.
I never quite understood why she's attempting to kill us with the same kind of enemies that we've fought and defeated quite easily throughout the entire DLC. So here we just fight these Scarlet Crew people. Eventually it'll make two lieutenants spawn? I think two. It's Lieutenant White and Lieutenant Hoffman. Now you can run all the way back through the lighthouse, but you don't really have to. There's a one-way teleport right here. You can see it's malfunctioning. All the one-way teleports are kind of broken. So, no traveling back to it, but we can travel from it. And we're back in Wormwater. Okay, let's get a vehicle. It doesn't really matter, but okay. And follow her to the beacon. Cool little cutscene here. And apparently we've been eaten. By the Leviathan. We've also eaten a still functional ammo dump. splutch.
So the bad news is the Leviathan swallowed us. The good news is it's taking us to the treasure room. But the best news is, do you remember my pet Roscoe? I found him!
Vagina face! Vagina face already existed in Borderlands 1, but he is... he's back! Yeah. I don't know if this pistol is particularly special. I know nothing much happens if you pick it up. Okay. Just looking to see if I can get some ammo. Doesn't look like it. I mean, I'm not desperately low, but you know. So yeah. In this light, these item indicators all have a weird, slightly unusual color. So I know I've run around here and thought, oh wow, a legendary dropped and run back in there and it turned out to just be money. Because the light's a bit weird, so it looks a bit orange, not just yellow. This looks like a sphincter muscle. And yet he just spat us out. So you want to hit the blue glowing bits. Like that one. The one on the other side, there's one on his chest. There we go. Now there's only one left in his mouth. That's a bit more difficult to get to, though.
My training's paying off.
Right here, you basically need to wait, kill these sandworms until eventually start a new attack. Come on, show me your tongue. And this is a point where you can hit it. Alright, so, I don't know, I always found this boss fight a bit lackluster, but you can now hop onto this and make your way to the treasure of the sands. They're doing something very nasty here. I don't know. So you go in here. The credits play.
The Vault Hunters defeated the treacherous Captain Scarlet and slew the Leviathan. And as the sun set on Pandora, the Vault Hunters realized that while they'd found Captain Blade's lost armory, the true treasure of the sands had been inside them all along. The end. How was that?
That last part was really hokey.
Yeah, it felt kind of contrived, didn't it?
Extremely. But otherwise, you ended that story pretty well for a dirty little orphan.
Thanks.
Ah, don't mention it. I gotta teach somebody to tell these stories when I'm gone. Might as well be you.
Yeah. I love you, Marcus.
That's weird.
Okay, I'm just gonna skip it. Yeah, first time we went through this, we thought, okay, they're playing the credits now, so it's over, so you don't actually get the treasure. That would have been quite sort of hilarious in a trolley way, but yeah, as it turns out, you do get the treasure, you just need to let the credits play out or skip them. And the majority of treasure chests are up there, but there's actually one down below. I don't think this is a way to get to it, though. I think we need to make... Oi! Yeah, this should work. Don't remember which level it was on precisely. No, it's fairly low on this side. Don't remember where exactly though. But if you jump too low, it becomes difficult to get back up again because you can only jump these half-height stones. You can't jump all the way up a level. Would be a bit annoying if I already missed it, but I definitely want to show you, so... Ah, here we go.
How about that?
You get some badass tokens, and this is one of the chests that has the greatest chance of containing good loot. But it remains just a chance. Jumped a bit too early there. And then getting back up is basically a quest to find these stones at half height. Wow, not half height. Not sure if this is the best way, but it definitely is one that works. Yeah, you can't go under that bridge for some reason. But okay. We're getting there. It's obviously a lot faster if you just... If you can ignore the one down there if you like. But I know the first two times I was here, I didn't even know it existed. So ever since then, I feel like I'm missing out if I don't get it. Oi. Oi! How difficult can it be to jump around a corner? Apparently very. Okay, so the loot in this DLC generally I found to be very, I don't know, poor. Especially in the end, this treasure room thing. I got pretty much nothing this time around. I think there's exactly one purple item. This artifact here. Which is pretty useless. And really, well, I guess the iridium's nice. But that's really it. You can get legendaries from it, but I don't think the odds are that great, so I don't know. I always found this very, disappointing. Even though the main part of this DLC is actually quite fun. Since we're almost done with it, by the way, I'm not going to end the episode. I'll just finish the DLC quickly. Yeah, there really isn't anything that I will do. There's one or two side quests that I haven't done, but, you know, just leave and be, I guess. You can always do these on your own. Next DLC would be Mr. Torque's Campaign of Carnage. And in that DLC I will definitely skip a lot of the side questing. Because it just isn't particularly fun. I feel that that second DLC is really the one where they ran out of ideas the most and just put in a lot of filler material to make it seem not quite so ridiculously short. So yeah. Pierfest. Come and get your feet wet. That's nice.
I have pressing news. A Hyperion engineer has gone mad with power out in the desert. Perhaps the alien thingies of this planet have perverted his mind or something. I don't know. I have a plan. We will shoot him many times with bullets and he will die. Be careful, though. He is very powerful. You may need to bring some friends as backup.
Is this the... I don't know. Anyway, let's sell this cutthroat combatant. I've already unlocked all the character modifications that there are in the game, so yeah. And you can now do the Lost Treasure quest again, basically. That's the only way you can get the... Well, it's the only legitimate way to get the... let me just ignore, and I guess ignore. Yeah, doing that quest again is the only way you can legitimately get back into the treasure chamber to get, well, more loot. There is another way. If you don't take the quest, the Leviathan corpse will be there, but the gate into the treasure chamber won't open. There is a way to get out of bounds, though, and, it's a bit of a complicated jumping thing, but you can get out of bounds and just drop into the treasure chamber from above and loot it that way. If you are so inclined, I never did it. I have no idea how hard those jumps are. There's guides on YouTube if you want to look it up. Okay, so I think that's all I want to do. I'm not going to be doing any of the raid quest, any of the raid boss stuff, anything like that. So I think the next thing we do is do Campaign of Carnage. So I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.